the Supreme Court of India set aside the ban put by the Reserve Bank of India on all the banks and financial institutions that were dealing with the virtual currency holders. Why the Reserve Bank of India did this? What was the case? What was the matter? Way back in 2018, the Reserve Bank of India, under its regulatory policies, directed all the banks and financial institutions not to deal or to give any services to all the people and the business entities who are dealing with cryptocurrencies, and on the basis of which the banks and the financial institutions seized all the accounts of those business entities and customers. Now in April 2018, Internet and Mobile Association of India, on the behalf of Indian crypto startups, filed a petition, a red petition in the Supreme Court against the Reserve Bank of India. This was not the first time that someone had filed a red petition in the Supreme Court. There were so many cases that were filed in the different high courts of the country. So when the matter went to the Supreme Court, it clubbed all the cases and gave a date for the hearing. The petitioner in the petition gave three basic arguments. Number one, the Reserve Bank of India had no capacity to issue such an order. Number two, the action of the Reserve Bank of India was absolutely arbitrary, and it was not within the purview of the regulatory authority of Reserve Bank of India. And it denounced all the economic activities in the country based on the nature of the activity alone. And number three, it violates Article 19(1)(g) of the Constitution of India that says all the citizens of the country have the right to practice any profession or can do any trade, business or occupation. On the basis of the arguments given by the petitioner, the Supreme Court of India had to go for a proportionality test. So what is a proportionality test? Under the doctrine of proportionality test, the Supreme Court of India checks the validity of the administrative action taken by the Reserve Bank of India. In this particular test, we compare the advantages and the disadvantages of the action taken by the Reserve Bank of India. If we find that the advantages are more than that of the disadvantages, then we consider the action of the Reserve Bank of India to be appropriate. But at the same time, the test must pass the test of Article 19(1)(g) of the Constitution of India. If it fails, then the administrative decision taken by the Reserve Bank of India would be considered invalid. Now let us understand the virtual currency and cryptocurrency. Globally, there is no particular definition given to virtual currency. There are different opinions among the users about the definition of virtual currency. Some users say that it is a mode of exchange, and some people say it is a commodity or a product or goods. A person named as Satoshi Nakamoto conceptualized the idea of modern virtual currency called Bitcoin and the underlying technology blockchain. He defined Bitcoin as a new electronic cash system which works between peer-to-peer without any centralized authority. That means it works in a decentralized manner. There is no third party. And all the virtual currencies are present in a globally visible ledger, and all the users of that technology are able to see them, they are able to track them, and this is what happens. Virtual currency is a term that has given to all forms of non-fiat currencies that are traded online. Also, it can be created, distributed and accepted in local virtual network. On the other hand, cryptocurrencies have extra layer of security in terms of algorithm and encryption. Cryptographic methods are used in order to make the network so secure where the cryptocurrencies are traded. The Reserve Bank of India in the year 2013 gave a warning to all the virtual currency holders about the potential risk associated with it. The next year, the Financial Action Task Force, which is the intergovernmental organization founded in the year 1989 on the initiative of G7, to develop policies on money laundering. It came out with a report about the legitimate use of virtual currency and the potential risk associated with it. In another report, it said that the use of virtual currency became very fast in the terror financing groups. So on the basis of the report given by the Financial Action Task Force and the excessive volatility of virtual currency, and the anonymous nature of the currency which goes against the global money laundering policy, Reserve Bank of India ko ye laga ki mujhe mere data ko pehle protect kar lena chahiye, And at the same time, I need to protect the consumers and have to have the proper monetary policy in the country. Aisa sochkar, usne sare virtual currency holders aur unke economic activities ko band kar diya. On this, the argument of the petitioner that the action of the Reserve Bank of India was outside its purview, as the non-fiat currencies are not actually the currencies. Second, that the decision of the Reserve Bank of India was very harsh, since it did not conduct any studies or any research on the basis of which it could prove that there was an economic threat due to the virtual currency network. Hence, on the basis of this, the Supreme Court of India finally concluded that the Reserve Bank of India, when put a ban, it did not pass the proportionality test, and also the ban violates Article 19(1)(g) of the Constitution of India. And on the basis of this, the Supreme Court of India also said, since there is no economic harm so far took place, therefore this is not legitimate to have the ban on the virtual currency network. And this particular decision came in the favor of all those people, all those users whose money are freezed because of the decision of the Reserve Bank of India. Now they are able to move ahead and they are able to conduct all the economic activities in the country. Hame ab ye dekhna hai ki ye log kaise kaam karenge, kitni imandari se kaam karenge, aur ye system kitni imandari se chalega, aur kya hamara legislation, kya hamara parliament isme koi kanun bana sakta hai, ye aage dekhne ko milega. Thank you so much. I am Biswajit Datta, Success Ahead Education Services, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh.